Hello, it's me again, and in the meantime, we have also received stable Diffusion 3.5 medium. That's why I'm now reporting again shortly after the large model video, because we'll take a look at that now. And I'll show you what I've already found out so far. And we start here on the comfy.org webpage. Look here in the blog, and here we see again stable Diffusion 3.5 medium in ComfyUI. We click on it and see Happy Halloween with 3L. I don't know who was responsible for the selection of the pictures here. It wasn't that great with large either. I don't know if I should like it or not. It doesn't look as cherry-picked as usual, but it doesn't matter. Come on, let's look further. It starts very interesting right away. It says here, stable Diffusion 3.5 medium to run on consumer GPUs with 2.6B parameters, and it supports resolutions from 0.25 to 2 megapixels. And I found that very interesting. We'll get through that again in a moment. Here you also get all download links credentialed. I'll open that up. That goes here on the Hugging Face page of Stability AI for the model. We'll take a quick look at that in a moment. Otherwise, you can also download clip G, L and T5. I guess one or the other already has it anyway, because that's what you need for Flux and for Large too. And here we can also download a workflow. I'll open that up too. There we actually come to the example page of the ComfyUI GitHub page. Otherwise, there is an easiest way to start down here. There is a package checkpoint. This package checkpoint has already baked the clips. I looked at it, but I let it be quickly. I also don't know which clip variants have been built in there. Because we'll see again that we also have this construct like in the original large workflow. Even if I took another one in my video. But I'm still with the triple clip loader. I don't know what is used here for the packaged. That's why you can look at it, download it, look at it. The advantage here is that you can just put the whole thing in a normal load checkpoint. And then the clip out here in the prompts. It doesn't hurt to just put a triple clip loader on it and use it. The results I had so far were much better. I'll close that up here. Let's take a look at the Hugging Face page. Here we have a lot of information. Also a bit of background. Also the typical SAI license. Take your time to check it out. Down here is the interesting part, progressive training stages, from 256 to 1440 pixel resolution. And that covers what we just saw, 0.25 to 2 megapixels. But we'll get through that. As a workflow. That was the other link I just opened, I showed you. Let's just take the standard workflow, pull and drag it over, and there it is. I'll clean up a bit back here. I would like to save that in SD35M. But I'm pulling it down again. You know that's for my thumbnails. And here we take a preview image. Here we have some more information. You are welcome to read through it, but we don't need it for the video now. We'll clean up a bit here. I only take the triple clip loader, that's why I throw the two away. So that we have something a bit clearer. I'll choose our model. That's the SD35 medium. And we'll put the sampler in. I'll take seed 0 and fixed. But I go up to 40 steps here. Reduce the CFG again a bit. Because it was in this area before. Then it was more comparable and better. I'll take the DPMPP2M. And we can leave SGM uniform. So I'm not going to try in the video to create the best pictures as possible, but just a little bit, that we also have a rough comparison to the prompts that I showed in the large video. So what you can clearly see, medium is smaller than large. That's not surprising when I say that, I know. But of course you notice that too. For this it is also with 5 GB much smaller than large. And also much faster when generating pictures. And we also have a base model here. That too, as far as I understand it, is not an extract of the large model, but a self-trained model. Which of course also ensures that we can train very well on it, and can bring out fine-tuned versions. But let's see. First of all, I take the prompt with the cat. I don't say Q5 here yet, but SD35 again. So, I'll leave out negative conditioning again. I used it occasionally when testing, but then again with the... I'll show it to you. SD3 negative conditioning. Come on, let's build it up. I use that. We remember. This ensures that the negative conditioning is only used up to 10% of the image generation, and after that no longer, whether it is necessarily necessary. So far it looked like it worked better, because SD35 just doesn't like negative conditioning normally. But pictures were also generated if you didn't do it. But I would still do it. So down here again the old move, because I'm lazy. Once briefly the width and the height, I take the SDXL aspect ratios out of here. From the comfy rolls I say I want a 3 to 4 portrait. And now we can actually run the whole thing. And there we have our picture. Didn't work out that well now. Although you can see it a bit up here, the place has become a bit ugly. It doesn't say SD35 here, but SD5. By the way, I also discovered that with the large model, that SD35 sometimes automatically becomes SD5. The tail is slid back here. We can now try again. If we now take a little more negative promptings, I'll zoom in. Start the whole thing once. And here we see that it has become much nicer. A latent place now appears up here. Here we still have SD5. I also have to say that it is always a bit of seed luck. That was the case with the large model. That's the same here. Down here we have a photo hallucinated. Nevertheless, the three negatives have already made a lot of difference for 10% in the generation. As you can see here. And with prompting you can do a lot more. Funnily enough, when testing, I had said at large, I don't know if branded names are trained. With a random seed, I suddenly had the Disney logo on a marquee in the background. So it seems to have been in the training. I found something like that quite interesting. Especially because I said it in the large video. That I don't know if that was included or not. What I can say very quickly is that image-to-image works just as normal as we are used to. Just as I did in the large video. Upscaling also works. I'm not going to show you that now. I tried it. It worked without any problems. Be it now, if I just scaled up the picture normally, and then I went into a second pass aka image to image, or if I did upscale using model, that was not a problem at all. We don't have to share like in a large video or the large model, which is only trained for a certain pixel area. That works here, and I think that also has to do with what we... Now I closed it. What we saw down here. That we have a multi-resolution training here. And that's good for us now. Because, look, I'll take another prompt now. And I take our assassin prompt, which I also had in the large video. But here we have to adjust a few things. Upper body shot bothered me. But I changed that a bit. These lines in action pose running. Her face is visible with a dense facial expression. And as negative I took horror and hair here. In my tests I could see very well that the things that I actually entered into the negative prompting were then also very constantly implemented again in the image generation. In my tests, assassins came out with hoods. But behind the hoods there was still hair to see. And that's why I took hair out here. And that worked very well. I go down a bit with the CFG. And I would say we try that now with the SDXL ratio. Also for me to see if I'm still in the right path. And I am. And that's a very nice picture. Here we have a bit of seed paint again. Or missing seed paint. Because the hand is of course correctly written. But we see that the letters are actually pulled apart. That can be okay stylistically. It bothers me a bit when something is written like that. Nevertheless, we got a very nice picture here. We have the watercolors again. We have our assassins with the cloak. The hair has been left out. Well, up here we can still see a few. But that's appropriate. Everything is black. I think it's nice how many black tones you get here. The large model could do that very well too. But what we can still see here is that we have a bit of this, I'll call it SD35 problem. That the face somehow drifted too much into the realistic. But you can also correct everything with prompting or block manipulation. We're still at the beginning. Nevertheless, we got a very nice basic picture from this base model medium, with which you can work. Now we have another thing. We have seen that the thing has been trained to different sizes. I could go here now and say, I take the CR15 aspect ratio and hang it in here. And say here too, I want a 3:4 portrait. And let that run. And here I don't even need to speed up the video. It just works super super fast. And here we already have our picture. And even in the resolution we have a really nice picture. So we are here now in the stable diffusion 1.5 size range. And that's already a very good result for it. However, we can also go up. And that's why I also saved the upscaling. I just told you that it works. We can now also let me do a little bit of tinkering. We say now we want to have an aspect ratio. I just take the SDXL. I take an empty image. And say width and height I would like to be able to control from the outside. And hang that in here. Now we create an empty picture in SDXL formats. Now I say I want this picture once on. Wait a minute, I'll connect it. No, we don't have to connect here yet. But I need a bit of space back here. I want to change this picture to 1440 pixels in height. As an interpolation, I can take nearest extract or something. This is a bit more resource saving, because we don't really want to scale the picture. But in the end, we just want to get the image size that we have created here, so that we can hang the width and height in our empty SDXL image. And so we have now created a picture, which is basically much bigger. And I'll let that run now. And there we are done. And even in this size it worked very, very well. And we see back here we even get a bit of paper patterns. Here again this effect with the face can be seen. Of course, they can also be a bit different from scene to scene. But I think it's good that we see it. It looks like a photo that was later edited with a filter. While this could already be watercolors. But we have the font, light shadows, we have the splashes here. I think it's nice how the coat goes into these watercolors. And so that you can see that, I'll open it here. We really have a height of 1440 and 1120 in the width. So that gets the medium model pretty good. It was said that we are in the megapixel area. If you want to work in the megapixel area, then you can also use the ComfyUI own image scale to total pixels node. I could also hang them in between here. We'll take them out so that it's a bit clearer. Here you would also have the opportunity to specify megapixels directly. I can also say here, we want to have a stable diffusion 1.5 resolution here, which is much lower with 512 by 682 than up here. Nearest extract doesn't matter. But we say now, I want to have 1.5 megapixels here. Then that is also cut directly to the right size. But then you no longer have the control that you want a certain target size. But then you can control that you want to go specifically to a megapixel area. Yes, whether this construct is absolutely necessary down here. I have now built it out of my laziness. That I just build myself a small canvas. Then, depending on the need, scale here. And then take the calculated size for the canvas, for the noise. Maybe you have better options. Probably even. I did it now on the fast one, but it also works. And you can easily hang a few things here. And check different resolutions. By the way, our picture is finished up there. I just see. Let's take a look, so you can hang around here a bit. and the whole thing works. By the way, I don't take the empty latent out here. If you also take the comfy rolls, but SD3 empty latent, mainly in one channel. Instead of 4 or in the shape are once 4 channels in the normal empty latent, and 116 in the SD3 latent image. That's why I'm staying here, is, I think, more compatible. So let's take a look at the picture. And that worked out pretty well too. Down here he slipped a bit when writing. But nevertheless, it is also very, very beautiful. Unfortunately, the hand has a bit of bad luck, like them, but we know that with SD3 media, we're waiting for fine tunes. What they can still knock out. Otherwise, stylistically it's good. Compared to the large, of course, a little inferior, let's say. It's not surprising either. It's a smaller model. And that's what we just read. It's meant for consumer GPUs. But also here with great anticipation, I expect the extensions. So fine-tunes, IPAs, control nets, etc. We have with large and medium actually pretty good base models, which can now be expanded. So, and yes, I hope it's also clear why I didn't show upscaling. It works just fine. You see, not like with large, where we have problems in higher pixel numbers. But that's how it goes. And we can actually even do it initially. Partly. Of course, I don't have all the motifs and so tested. I'm a little bit with mine. I stayed with my standard motifs, so that I can compare it a little better with the large. I think we'll all be there together for the future and collect enough knowledge. And gradually refine everything. Yes, I hope you get a good entry into the model. You can play around with it yourself and experiment around. Especially because it's a little smaller. I'm even up here on the T5 FPG. I stayed with the T5 FPG 16 and it went fast. Here you could probably also use the FP8 and save a little bit again. But just try it out. I'll see you in the next video. Take care until then and bye.